Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. It's Rocio, also known as Queen Ro. Anyway, I'm back with another video, you guys, and this video is going to be my review and a makeup look that I just did using colors from the Hard Candy Rose Gold palette. Right now, it is my absolute favorite palette to use. It is affordable, and guys, it is such a good find. This is basically a steal for one of those higher-end eyeshadow palettes that are very, very popular right now. I'm not gonna name any, but this will create looks that I believe for the fall and for the summer, and even now transitioning into the winter, I think that they will come in handy 100%. I have a positive review coming up, so stay tuned. I'll show you how to create this look. And thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe at the bottom because there are more videos, more reviews coming up. So if you wanna stay on top with my reviews, my 100% positive reviews, please subscribe, like this video, and comment down below if you want to see anything else, if you have any questions for me. Follow me also on social media. My Instagram is QueenRo7, as you can see right over here. Also on Facebook, I am Rocio MENA, which is my last name, Rocio Mena. All the links will be down below, so stay tuned because I'm going to show you how to create this look with this affordable hard candy palette. Stay tuned, you guys. I love you so, so much. Beautiful, 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 beautiful angel. Love your imperfections, every anger. Hi guys, how are you? So the first thing that you want to do for this look is take your palette. And of course, I already have foundation on. I moisturize my face and prime my face. For moisture, I use the Renew in a Jar by Purity. It's the Philosophy Moisturizer. And I also use the Smashbox Primer. And that's how I basically prepared my face before the foundation. The foundation that I'm using today is the Becca Cosmetics foundation, and I really, really, really like it. I like how it is set on my face. I'm trying it today for the first time, and so far, so good. So let's go in and use our Hard Candy Rose Gold palette. And this is not an expensive palette, you guys, but right now it is my go-to favorite palette that I am using on a daily basis, almost, I guess, to create most of my looks. So the first thing that you want to use, the first color that you want to use, pardon me, is this color right here. It's kind of hard for me to read the colors. I think this one is because they are like up and down. I don't really know which one I'm pointing to, but it is, if I'm not mistaken, I think it's roses. This one is called roses. So this one is the color that I use on my whole eyelid. So I go in with a regular flat brush for eyeshadows. This is just one of those brushes that I've had for a really, really long time. These are the eco-friendly brushes that you can get at Walgreens. They don't even have to be anything expensive, you guys. Like, seriously, you don't need an $80 brush to create a nice eye look. So you're just gonna go in and just pat this one on your eyelid. So I use, for the look that I'm going for today, is something not too drastic. It's a day look, but it's nothing that is going to be too exaggerated. Right now, I am into those fall colors, something nice and neutral, but at the same time with a little bit of pop in color. I'm just gonna use a mirror real quick. So I'm going in on my whole eyelid, as you can see. And then, you guys, I'm going to go in with a darker color, and I'm taking, sorry, I'm hitting the. So this brush is the blending brush by Glamour Dolls. This is basically a regular blending brush. And I'm gonna go in with a darker color for this one. I'm thinking of going in with possibly just a little bit of this red color right here. That is called Heartbeat. So I'm gonna go in with Heartbeat. So with this color, I'm not going in too much. And I'm just gonna go in the crease area. That color has a lot of pigmentation, you guys. So that's why I try to be as careful as possible and not to overdo it with this color, because it could get very overwhelming on my eye, and that's not the look that I want right now. I'm just gonna go in on the other side as well. Now this palette is so beautiful. It's affordable. It's only $10. I got it at Walmart, and I highly recommend it. If you're on a budget, definitely, or if even if you're not on a budget, if you just want some cute colors for this fall that can be used also to transition into the winter, or even for a nice little eye look for Thanksgiving or just for a date night. So I'm just blending in those colors. And now, you guys, I'm gonna go in with a bronzy color. I'm gonna try to do maybe the gold one in the center. Now, with this color, you definitely want to wet your brush, okay? So I'm gonna grab something real quick just to wet my brush. Another thing that I also like about this palette, guys, is that it comes with two little brushes, and they're so cute. They come with two brushes like this. One is a little bit finer that you can use for your eyeliner, and another one is thicker. And there's another brush that I have right around here that comes with this palette as well, and it's a little bit looser. It's a little one. I will definitely use this one to create some looks, but for now, as you can see, I already used it. It's a little dirty. I have to wash that. But we're gonna go in with the other one. That's a little bit more of a blending brush, a small blending brush. So I'm gonna take any setting spray. I'm gonna go in just in the center of the eye, just to add a little bit of color, a little bit of dimension in there. And you want to be careful with this because you don't want it to go all over the place. I'm just going to add this in the middle. This is a very, very beautiful gold color. As you can see, it's coming on very, very pretty. And I'm going to go in with the gold color. This gold is specifically called Marry Up. I'm gonna go in with Marry Up. And again, it's going to be the same process. We're going to apply it right in the center. Make sure you are applying this and dabbing in a dabbing motion, because you don't wanna smear it on and then have the color go all over. For my highlight, I'm going to go in with this little color right here. It's at the other corner, and if I'm not mistaken, I believe it's diamond. So I'm gonna go in with diamond. It also has a little mirror here, so you don't have to be flipping back and forth with your original mirror. I'm gonna go in and just highlight the brow bone. Now at work, I get asked a lot about my eyebrows. Like, what do you use for your eyebrows? Usually what I recommend is the Anastasia Brow Kit or the brow pencil or the clay pot. But we also have a Sephora collection brow kit, and there's something very similar to that. I don't have the Sephora collection brow kit, but I do have something extremely, extremely similar to that. And that is the, I got this at like the dollar store or something like that. I saw it, I liked the colors, and I wanted to try it out, and it worked out for me. So I think I paid like $2.99 for this. And this is the Broadway Colors Eyebrow Kit. It has, this is very well loved, you guys. I already hit pan on this color. But it comes with a little spoolie and a little eyebrow brush. I don't really use that. And I have this, it's so dirty right now. I really don't use that at all. Like the little gel, I rarely use it. But I use this color right here because I have dark hair. I like to go in with a dark brown color. And I take a angled brush. I think this is the Echo Tools. I think so. I think I only use the Echo Tools. I take the angled brush by Echo Tools. I'm sure you guys can get anything similar to that. It's angled and it's just absolutely perfect. I will show you really quick. I feel like a lot of people don't show how they do their eyebrows, and some people do. So I'm just gonna go in on the bottom, and I just do a line at the bottom on both sides. I'm gonna need a mirror for this one because I can't go just by what I'm seeing on the camera. I'm gonna go in and do another line at the bottom. Now, this is powder. You could also do this with a pencil. And I'm gonna go in and do another line at the top. Notice that I don't do it from the beginning because there we're gonna do a different process. Then through there, I just fill in my brows. And I go and do up motions in the inner brow area. That's how I basically just go in and do that, you guys. Like, I don't even do anything all that complicated. I rarely use concealer to define, although I think I should. Then I go in, I take the brush, add more product on there, make sure I'm covering my natural brow shape. I don't do anything outside of my brow shape. I just fill in what I already have. So we're gonna go in with this dark plum color. Thank you. So I feel like that just opened my eye up so much and it made it look so much better. Now I'm getting another brush and I'm just brushing away all the excess that I have from all the shadows that I applied. All right, so very quickly, because I don't want to make this video too long, I'm using the Clarins mascara. I've used this for so long. Like, I really, really like this one. This is the color one. It's the darkest one they have. It's intense black. And this is the mascara Supra Volume. I feel like this mascara gives me so much volume compared to a lot of others that I have used. So I normally do two coats. And then I go in with a L'Oreal mascara as well, just to give it that extra voom. If you are one of those girls that has short lashes just like me, you're definitely going to understand where I'm coming from. I feel like it's so difficult to find that one mascara that just gives you volume and length as well without leaving them clumpy. I feel like this mascara does just that for me. And I'm gonna go into my lower lash line as well. For my second coat of mascara, I'm just gonna go and use the L'Oreal Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara. And it has like a little bit of glue in it, like eyelash glue that I had on there. Okay, so this is just going to give me more intensity because this is relatively a new mascara. And I feel like the newer the mascara is, the more difficult it is for me to get that voluminous look. That's why I pair it with the other mascara that I've had for a little bit more time. So you see that difference there? Like, I'm just combing my lashes up. Combing, 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 and brushing it up. That's giving me that volume that I want because today I'm just decided to not go in with some falsies because I'm not into that life right now. I don't want to do falsies right now. I'm just gonna do mascara, 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 mascara until I get what I want. Mascara, 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 mascara.
Oh, I feel so better boop right now.
Alright, so, all joking aside, last but not least, of course, I do have to contour and highlight, honey. So, what am I gonna use to contour? The original contour palette by Anastasia. Hit pan and it's completely gone. Hit pan and it's completely gone. So all I use now is, I think I should get, you know what? I think I could just order that banana color. Mm-hmm. I think I'm gonna do that. All right, honey, so I'm gonna use this contour brush by Wet n Wild. Yes, I use Wet n Wild. They're actually pretty good. I haven't had any shedding whatsoever for my contour over here. I need a mirror, honey. Okay. I contour a little bit higher because I want a more snatched face. You see, I want a face that's just a little bit more snatched today because, can you see that right there? Like, why are you even giving me that right now? Like, don't mind my hair. My hair is just all over the place. So I'm just gonna do a little bit on the jawline, a little bit of contour in the jawline as well. I'm gonna get this double chin to disappear, or at least try to disappear it. All right, honey, so that's enough for the contour. And I do like to wear a blush, but today I'm just not going to. So I'm gonna use just a bronzer by Wet n Wild. This is the Fergie edition Center Stage collection. Like, I've had this forever and it's so freaking amazing. Like, I really love it. Can you see that? And all this is so well loved. Ugh, freaking amazing. Anyway, I'm gonna take a Clear Cosmetics brush. I usually use this for color purposes. Just gonna apply a little bit of highlight on the apples of my cheeks. Not too much though. Just a little bit right there. Just so when I smile, I look approachable. Like I wanna talk to you. Like, come over here and talk to me, honey. But it also gives me a little bit of glow. See that? Gives me color and it gives me a little bit of glow. Like, my mood just changed. You see how makeup just makes you feel more alive? At the beginning of this video, I know it's a little boring, but for some reason, as I am doing my makeup, I just got a little bit more of energy, if you know what I mean. All right, my love. So, the look is almost done. I am going to use just a little bit of this because I see some shine in the middle of my forehead here. Just gonna go in real quick. Clean any excess off. And I also like to apply, because we are using this palette, you know what? We're gonna use the Hard Candy palette. Just because we are using this rose gold palette, we're gonna go in with some highlight. Just the same highlight that I used on here. We're gonna use that highlight. I'm gonna take a little brush. This is, I don't even know what brush this is, but this is a highlighter brush. We're gonna go in and apply some highlight. Let's see how that looks there. Give me highlight. Can't see it that well on this side, but give me highlight, honey. Yep. She glows. Oh, she glows. Perfection. Very good. All right, honey bunny. So I'm just gonna finish this look off with a nice nude lip just to even things out on my face. And for this look, I'm gonna use the LA Colors. Yes, mama, LA Colors lippies are amazing. This is so good. This is such a good formula. It doesn't dry out my lips. This is the LA Colors Matte Liquid Lip Colors. My loves, I have to give two thumbs up to LA Colors on this one because it is just absolutely gorgeous. It goes on wet, but as it dries, it gets. And like your lips get so, I don't know what it is. Like, it just works. This formula works with your lips. And it just gets like so enhanced. There you go. LA Colors coming through with these lippies. If you guys cannot afford the expensive lippies, like me, because I cannot afford all the expenses, so I can't afford to spend $50 on a lippie, or $30 or $40 or $50 on a lippie every now and then. I can't. Like, it adds up, you guys. I got bills to pay. This is only $1.99. And the formula is sickening. sickening. I think I'm gonna do two layers of this. Yep. I feel like this nude doesn't wash me out or anything. And it just works with me. Bear with me, guys, because right after this, I'm filming a review on hair. So you're gonna see like a back to back. And you're gonna see me wearing the same clothes and everything. So I'm filming it back to back. That's why I don't have like my hair completely done, although I should have. And then just use, I don't know. Like, is that palette a yes or a no? In my book, it is a complete yes. Why? Well, because first of all, the colors are very pigmented for the price that you're paying for it. Second of all, they are very, very beautiful. They aren't creamy, they aren't dry, but that formula is very, very blendable as well. So I'm not sponsored by Hard Candy or anything like that, but guys, do go out and get this palette if you want to save a couple bucks and not spend so much on a palette. Like, I don't have $50, $60, $80 to spend all the time. I'm not at that level yet. Look at me just fixing my hair. I'm not at that level yet, and even if I was, I will still go out and purchase these more affordable palettes because, hey, if I'm gonna save money while getting good stuff, good quality stuff that I can work with on my eyes and possibly on clients, then yes, definitely. So 100% thumbs up, go out, get the Hard Candy palette. It's only like $9.99, $10. I highly recommend it. I'm not sponsored or anything, not affiliated with Hard Candy, but you can find it at Walmart, and I believe it's also Walmart online. So yeah, that's all. Stay tuned because up next I'm going to be recording a hair review on a new wig that I absolutely love. So stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.